So my parents and sister wanted to spend some family time together, so after a genuinely enjoyable meal filled with fun conversation and actual bonding, they decided an even better way to bond was to sit quietly in a dark room filled with other people while watching Will Ferrell make poopy jokes for an hour and a half.
Can I get 5 beers? This one's for Dylan and Megan and Sarah and Dylan, and nothing but that.
So you know how teenagers often get low-paying, entry-level jobs at fast food places? Jobs they get and perform not because they have a profound love for the menial task of flipping burgers, cleaning bathrooms, or dealing with crazy customers. Jobs they perform not out of respect for the company or craft of cooking, but jobs they get and perform for the sole purpose of getting paid so that they can buy their hoverboards, snap rats, and rap music or whatever. Jobs they don't try and excel or strive for perfection with, but rather simply perform at the most basic, necessary level, with the lowest effort possible, that still keeps them making money. Well, the new film from Will Ferrell and Mark Wahlberg, Daddy's Home, is that teenager working at a fast food place.
Hey kids,
there's someone here now that I hope you guys can learn to love.
A doggy! Yay!
I thought you were talking about me.
Oh, but you're not a dog, Brad.
Why is he looking at me like that?
No!
So what do we got going on over here, man?
It's a treehouse. We've only been at it for about 2 months.
Daddy's Home is the definition of being low effort and bland. If there was a 1 to 10 scale of effort, 1 being the lowest effort possible, 10 being the highest effort possible, Daddy's Home wouldn't even be ranked. It'd still be at home, in bed, asleep, and hungover, not bothering to even show up. It was so bland that if you asked me to recount what happened in the movie 30 minutes after I finished watching it, you'd think I'd have Alzheimer's. The one and only reason this movie was made was the executives at whatever movie studio and wherever land Hollywood decided that the bank account needed some replenishing. Add in the fact that Will Ferrell and Mark Wahlberg wanted to get paid, and there you go. Daddy's Home is born.
Did you just punch me in the face, Brad?
Oh, yes.
For all 2 of you interested in knowing about the plot, let me inform you. It doesn't matter. The movie doesn't care about the plot, and the characters don't care about the plot. It's there solely to keep the space for jokes going, and that's it. But to sum it up, Will Ferrell plays a goofy, effeminate stepdad trying to gain the affection of his stepchildren. But when their super cool, adventurous bad boy dad, played by Mark Wahlberg, comes home, shenanigans ensue in a situation that would normally result in legal action, calls to the cops, domestic disputes, and restraining orders. If you go into this movie looking for jokes, I really hope you enjoy yelling, people getting hurt, and curse words.
He's giving the kids all kinds of starbursts.
Damn it!
Sorry. I'm a hot habanero pepper right now.
Because who needs setups and punchlines when Will Ferrell can just fall down and yell? Also, I'm pretty sure this movie was just an ad for the Ford Flex, as the second line in the movie was Will Ferrell essentially saying, "Also, I love my Ford Flex as it seats 6 comfortably and gets great mileage." Mark Wahlberg says something similar towards the end of the movie as well. Now, I'm hoping this was just a purposeful over-exaggeration, therefore creating a commentary of sorts and a joke on product placement. But with how low effort this movie was, something leads me to believe that it's not, and that it's just there because... money. Now, I don't want to seem too pessimistic and cynical. There were some parts of the movie I found memorable and enjoyable. Those parts being Linda Cardellini's body parts. But seriously, there were some things I liked. For instance, Hannibal Buress is one of the supporting characters, and even though his lines aren't the best, I just generally enjoy his delivery and demeanor as an actor-comedian enough to make him enjoyable in the movie. Also, there's a cameo at the end, so yeah, why wouldn't that be a positive? January truly is the bipolar month of movies. You've got bad crap like this movie playing, while at the same time you have award season movies playing. While watching Daddy's Home, theaters right next to me were showing movies like The Revenant, Spotlight, The Big Short, and The Hateful Eight. And good lord, what body parts I wouldn't have given up to be in any of those theaters instead of the one I was in.
I just want to watch The Revenant. Just let me watch The Revenant. Just let me watch it. Let me watch The Revenant. I cut off my hand so I could watch The Revenant. Just let me watch it. I cut off my hand. Just let me watch The Revenant. Just let me watch The Revenant, please. I got my hand. My hand. Ah!
Overall, I'm just disappointed by this movie, because I know how funny Will Ferrell and Mark Wahlberg can be together. I've seen the other guys several times and find it really entertaining and funny. I just know both of them have it in them to be better than this. So rather than watching this crap, go watch something good with Will Ferrell in it, like Stranger Than Fiction. And if you want to watch a Mark Wahlberg comedy, just go watch The Happening.
What? No!
So yeah, that's about all I have to say. Daddy's Home is a bland, forgettable studio product, made to get a quick buck that is surface-level funny, if you can even call it that. And no one will remember it in about half a year. When giving this a rating on a 1 to 10 scale, I can only be grateful that it isn't as effortless as an Adam Sandler movie, and not as stupid as one of those parody movies. I'm giving Daddy's Home a 4.5 out of 10. Do yourself a favor and, rather than seeing this, go see one of the good movies in theaters right now. Or heck, I don't care, go see Star Wars for like the fourth time.
No. Looks like we got ourselves a good old-fashioned dad off.
You can eat my dust, Dusty.
Is this already?
It's not, it's the middle of April.
What's this? Playoff tickets against the Los Angeles!
Not bad.
Dusty Mayron!
Hey, this is my family.
Well, come on
you
down.
Feel like Wolf Bob Ravanich, your friend.
Can I get five beers?
This one's for Dylan and Megan and Sarah and Dylan, but nothing but that.
Dylan and Megan, this is for you.
Okay, who's got next?
I do.
Honey, no. Come down.
Yeah, that's good advice.
Godspeed.
Did you just punch me in the face, Brad?
Ow, yes.
And yes, I know this review is hypocritical. Even though I say I'm so apathetic towards Daddy's Home and say it's so forgettable and not even worth the time or effort I just spent like 9 hours writing, creating, and editing this review. Well, I'm gonna go watch some Netflix and cry myself to sleep. Bye.
Who can make the sunrise?
Sprinkle it with you.
Cover it with chocolate.